Hi, I'm Julia with the Nisqually River Education Project, and today we're going to be creating and then testing a tool that scientists use to measure the turbidity of water. Turbidity just means how clear or cloudy a water sample is. Let's get started. For this project, here's what you'll need. A metal disc, a wooden stirring stick, a black marker, a pipe cleaner, some cornstarch, a little scoop, a bead, and we'll be using the cup that it came in as the vessel for our water. All you'll need to provide is the water itself. First, we're going to prepare our Secchi disc. Make sure that you have a piece of paper underneath the disc so you don't get any marker on your desk or your table. And then use the black marker in your kit to draw the checkerboard pattern right onto the disc, just like this. Next, you'll poke the pipe cleaner through the disc from the top, and you'll thread the bead onto the pipe cleaner. Then curve the pipe cleaner back around to poke through the disc again. Then give it a tug to secure it and make sure that that bead is snug up against the underside of your disc. Make sure that the checkerboard side is the side that's facing up, and make sure that the disc is laying flat. Feel free to wiggle it around and adjust the disc so that it lays nice and flat. Now your disc is ready. Next, we're going to prepare our water sample. So fill up the deli container with water to about an inch from the top and set it down on a stable surface. To use the Secchi disc, we're going to place the disc into the water and slowly lower it down into the cup. Keep lowering the disc until you can no longer see that checkerboard pattern, and then stop lowering it immediately. Since this first water is clear, it's going to go all the way down to the bottom of the cup and still be clearly visible. That's okay, this one is just about testing our technique. Next, you're going to use your other hand to pinch the pipe cleaner right at the point where it meets the surface of the water. Carefully pull the disc out, making sure that your hand stays pinched right in that spot. You'll then use the ruler to measure the length of pipe cleaner that was in the water, so the distance between where you're pinching and the top of the disc. And this value is called the Secchi depth. The greater the Secchi depth, the lower the turbidity is in the water. Once you have your value, you can let go of the pipe cleaner. You'll then record this Secchi depth onto your data sheet. Now we'll prepare our next sample. Into the same cup of water, add one heaping scoop of the cornstarch and stir it up using the wooden stirrer. Now lower the disc into the sample. Just like before, we'll keep lowering the disc until we can no longer see that checkerboard pattern, then we stop immediately. Just like before, we're gonna pinch that pipe cleaner right at the point where it enters the water and carefully pull the disc out. We'll use our ruler to measure the length of pipe cleaner that was in the water again, and we'll get this new Secchi depth value and record that onto our data sheet. Now it's time to make the next sample. Just like before, we're gonna add one more scoop of cornstarch and stir it up. So now we have two scoops of cornstarch in our sample. And we're just going to repeat this procedure again to get our new Secchi depth. Now we're going to prepare our next sample. So just like before, we're gonna add one more scoop of cornstarch. So now we have three total scoops. We're gonna mix it up, repeat that whole procedure over again, and get our new Secchi depth. And then finally, we're gonna do the same thing over again, adding one more scoop of cornstarch for a total of four scoops, stirring it up, lowering our disc in, and getting that new Secchi depth and entering that into our data sheet. Now you're all all done. Thanks for joining us for this project today. I hope you had a fun time making and testing these tools with us, and hopefully we'll see you around next time. Bye!